It's the biggest in the game, the big show, aka Mr. Viral is back. Now, what's up, y'all? I miss y'all. Let's get to it. Okay. Joe Crack the Don has never been a rat in his life. He's never told on a person in his life. I kill myself before I tell on somebody. Let's be clear about that, right? Now, with that being said, you have to realize, whether you know it or not, I'm at another level in my life. I work very, very hard to get to where I'm at. So I have friends, the biggest in the world, the biggest in the game, hitting me up. Yo, Joe, don't respond to these people. You bigger than that. Yo, Joe, don't this and this and that. They're trying to bring you down. Because you know that yesterday's price is not today's price. And mind you, I'm in Hermes. So now let me get this going, right? So now, today's about love or hate. Today's about love or hate. Now, meaning, we call people haters, but are they really haters, or do they hate that people love you? I repeat, we call people's haters, but do they really hate you, or they hate that people love you? Now, the type of shit that I'm about to talk about today might be the realest shit you ever heard in your life. Rich people, you can think about them, the biggest guys in the world. If you ever notice why they don't show how they're living, why they don't show their cribs, why they don't do that, think about your favorite artists, the richest people you know. It's because, unfortunately, people tend to get jealous of people living good and being successful. It's just a fact. Jealous ones still envy. And so they don't choose to show it. Now, Fat Joe, I come from the projects like you. I come from welfare like you. I come from the streets like you. And so when I show that we're in the plane, or we're having a great time, or we having a, it's only used for inspiration. It's used to inspire you to win. Now, people in the past have never given you this opportunity. People that came before me, even people now, we always have a crabs in a barrel mentality to where we pull everybody down and we never want to see them win or rise to the top. So now, should we focus on the haters, or should we focus on the people that hate that people love you? This is a big thing, right? So now I'm going to tell you some shit, and I don't want to offend nobody, because this is really real. And if you tell me, Joe, you're the greatest storyteller ever in the world, then let me tell you a story. I got a story to tell. Okay? Now don't get upset with me, because this is going to sound not true, but you can Google everything. Right? A month ago, I never talked about nothing. My brother Mutab Bell, Salam Alaikum, he's out in Saudi, formerly in the... Please don't call me if you have my number now, guys. I won't pick up ever again. My friend, Mutab Bell, a.k.a. Napoleon of the Outlaws, tells this story that I don't even believe. He says, 20-some years ago, Tupac Shakur, may he rest in peace, trouble in the jail, and Fat Joe sent the kite upstate to make sure he was good and he was protected. Now, the story's true. I talk a lot of shit, but I never told that story in 20 years. Because real dudes do real things. So he tells the story. Tupac's right-hand man says, "Yo, Fat Joe saved Tupac." That's hard for some people to digest. This is Tupac Shakur, who I has labeled the realest rapper on the planet Earth. Cool. The next 2 weeks later, Common, formerly Common Sense, gets on an interview. I never told this story in 20 years. He gets on an interview where he says, "Joey Crack, that brother saved my life. I was in LA and the Bloods was going to kill me, as in assassinate me, as in murder me. And Fat Joe jumped in front of it and said, please, because I'm not acting like I'm tougher than my people out there. But I said, listen, I grew up with him. Do it for me. Give me the pass. Do not hurt my brother Common. I grew up with him. He's my brother." He says this in the interview. I never asked him to say that. He says this in an interview. Fat Joe saved my life. Now, let's go forward. 2 weeks ago, we throw the Terror Squad emblem next to the Empire State Building. You seen the shit. You got eyes. You see me in that Hermes Tiffany blue. This hurt a lot of feelings. It hurt a lot of people. Brought out a lot of jealousy. Now, the place was small, so I didn't want to invite the whole New York City because they would have shut the shit down. Even friends of mine that I know have a problem with bringing people with them. I told them, get dressed, get your wife dressed, wear some silk shit. And that same night at 7 o'clock at night, maybe 8, I sent them the invitation so they wouldn't come with 15 dudes. If you're from New York City and you know I know you and I love you and you didn't come to the party, I'm sorry. It don't mean no disrespect. A lot of you guys got jealous behind that. So now we tell you about Mutah Bell with Tupac. We tell you Common Sense saying Fat Joe saved his life. Now Fat Joe throws the party of the year. Anybody you name was in there. Everybody, actors, the Canaan, the mother of Harlem, the this. Now there's one point. Chi-Chi get the yayo from Scarface. There's one point that really touched a lot of feelings. Shine Poe. Shine walks in New York City for the first time ever, changed his life, goes on stage, we all know Shine's history, and says, "You are the most honorable. You, 20 years I know you, you have the most integrity. You're the realest one. We love you." Now that is scary for you hating ass motherfuckers. Now, look at what's going on here. Look at what's going on here. We're doing, and mind you, when I seen the fuckery and the hate, I look back at my Instagram. And as I'm scrolling at my Instagram, I'm seeing private jets, Hermes, fly shit, opening businesses, Drew Barrymore in the hood, yachts. Damn. This is, I can see why why guys get jealous. I can see why there's hate in their blood, right? And so when I look at this, I say, wow. Now, you have to understand, I've been living a half a century with the cleanest face you've ever seen. A lot of guys, they ugly out there. They just ugly. They look tore up. They're not the same. I am, guys, the same guy. And so I see these guys, and I see where the hate comes from. And I said, man, these guys are washed up 20 years. We never spoke their name in 20 years. These guys are dumb. These guys, they washed up. So they clout chase me, and the only time somebody gets some type of action is when they mention my name, and then they got our likes or whatever the case may be. Now, Jay-Z once said, cut the grass low and you'll see the snakes. I always say, let your darkest moments bring your most clarity. So they want to fuck with the Teflon reputation. Guys, anybody who ever stepped in front of us, we washed them. Every single one of your favorite rappers, every single street dude, everybody, we washed them. Every time. Guys, I know I'm changed. I know stay in the light. I know I changed. Stay in the light. Ciroc, a much finer vodka. I'm talking too much shit, so I don't want to fuck up the Pepsi Connect. It's the Wild Cherry. It's still Wild Cherry Fridays. Everybody. We washed everybody. Facts. East Coast, West Coast, North, South, wherever. We laid it down. Okay? Now the guys are hating. But are they really haters? Or do they hate that people love us? That people show up to a party and show you love? That people show you sincere love? The people know I'm on here a year and a half telling you how to get to the bag. Just now, shout out MarketAmericaShop.com. I'm in North Carolina telling 40,000 unfranchised owners how to win. And so, this is the most fabricated, false paperwork I've ever seen in the history of mankind. This is like disgusting. Now, those names you see on there are actual people. Those people really went to jail for 20 years. You guys and your friends was locked up with them. You never heard Fat Joe ever talk. They don't even know me. Those guys on that paper, I never met them. They don't know me. So you put a little whiteout on a piece of paper and you write Joseph Cartagena's name. And you guys break my heart if you fall for that. You guys are disgusting. Because I am the one guy who's successful and still walk these streets to show you that there's no difference. You know, a lot of people, they get successful. And everybody's dream is, let's move out the hood. Everybody's dream is, let's make it out the hood. Some people, and most people, and not just famous, just successful people, they get a good job, get a business, they make it out the hood, they never come back. We never see them again. That's not it, guys. If you get success, why do you think I open up businesses in the hood and give inspiration and hope and opportunity? Because my businesses are nothing else but a baton, passing it to the next successful person out the hood and say, listen, we don't gotta leave. We don't got to go. We could be here and invest in our community. This is sparking an idea in some other people's minds. They don't have to be famous. Yo, let's open up businesses in our hood. Let's take care of our own. Let's give back food to the people who need it. Let's send, yo, you guys, man, some of you guys, man, you can't wash my socks, man. And it hurts my heart, man. When our people are in trouble in Puerto Rico, I send four planes, a million pounds of food and water. You guys, boys, y'all the first to talk shit. You break my heart, niggas. Y'all break my heart. Y'all break my heart. Because I'm the only thing smoking out there for you. It's horrible, bro. It's sad, man. And so they jealous. And so, Joe Crack, I see these guys. Some of them realer than other. Some of them are real legends. Just because you went to jail and you did some time don't make you a real legend. If we want to talk that street world. AB, what's good? Just because you did jail time doesn't make you a real legend. Oh, you a stand-up guy, you ain't tell? Thank God, hallelujah. That's what you were supposed to do. When you robbed the lady, or you hustled, or you did whatever you did, you ain't supposed to tell. We can't give you an award for that. That's just basic truth. You ain't do nothing special. You not no type of legend. I don't want to go back. I know we in the line. But you do know we had 47 cars at one time. Debated. You guys were getting extorted. Not me. Relax. I let you live in your world of fake world legends. And somebody called me today. Yo, Joe. I said, man, your man broke my heart, man. Nah, because I'm going to tell you the truth. I never liked your man. Anyway. But your man broke my heart. And you, let me ask you a question. A lot of guys had it popping in the street. A lot of guys got money. A lot of guys are real dudes and are legends. And when I see them, Fat Joe, I show these guys the utmost respect. The greatest respect you could give somebody. I said, let me ask you something. When I come around y'all, do I ever act like I'm better than y'all? Or I see legends from the street like that? Nah, Joe, you always humble, Joe. You always show us level. You guys break my heart, man. Because everybody out there, they know I was outside for real. You know this. And so people who co-signed a fabricated lie, you know it's a lie yourself. And so it's the bonchinche of the day. Let's get with it. It's the new thing. Yo, let's, bro. Embarrassing. See, I live by code. I don't sleep with my friends' wives. I never told. I give back. I take care of my family. My son's autistic. His mother wanted to give him away. I raise him. I'm the one. Percy T.S. is in on this, my brother. I don't expect you to do. What you want me to big you up, Percy? You went bad on there. You supposed to. Because when you was locked down, Fat Joe went to visit you every week. When the other dude, it breaks my heart. I got one dude that I was cool with that's a dope fiend that I went to visit him 16 years in jail. 16 years when he came home. I threw him a party. I bought him a Hummer. I gave him an apartment. This guy's talking about me because he's not with us no more. Because if you sniff dope, you cannot be next to Fat Joe. It's disgusting. But you tell me whatever rapper goes visit somebody 16 years in snowstorms and takes care of their family. Percy, no. When lights was out, who was there for him? They all know. They know Fat Joe paid for over 100 funerals in the hood. Come on, guys. You guys are disgusting. Embarrassing. To the code. To the code. And Tony Sunshine, yeah, he had his issues. You don't have them no more. And he got Rolexes and diamonds and lives great in palm trees, guys. You keep your bullshit to yourself. Anybody with me look good. Anybody not with me no more. Let me tell you something my wife told me one time. She said, Joe, you never let go of nobody. They fuck it up themselves. And I always, 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 always try to help people. No matter what. I had one friend down with me. He's from the hood. I tried to teach him manners. I took him to Dubai, to the fucking, the Prince of Dubai's palace. He had his pants to his fucking kneecap with his ass crack showing with the thing. Yo, I'm from the hood. I'm from the hood. I will fuck you up in this palace. Pick them shits up. Some niggas can't come. We can't help everybody. You try and they shit on it. Guys made your choice. Fabricating, you know, saying the type of things they saying, that's about the ugliest thing you could say to somebody, bro. That's one of them. That's up there. Clark Kent, what's up? Percy, what's up? Now, Percy, am I saying the truth? Yes or no? Yeah, you can't buy class. Breaking news. Pretty Lou, after 7 years, has just beat cancer. I repeat, after 7 years of fighting leukemia cancer, the brother beat the cancer. God is tremendous. A miracle has happened. I prayed for Pretty Lou hundreds of nights in a row. I had friends who were doctors who would tell me in my ear, yo, Joe, chill. You're too emotionally involved. People don't beat this kind of cancer. I said, don't talk like that about my brother. We're gonna fight till this shit is over. God showed himself. You know when you go to church and you see them people and they be like, oh, yes, Lord, Lord. I never really understood that. But when I get the phone call that Pretty Lou beats the cancer, I start crying. I'm not scared to say it. I start crying. I had to hang up on Pretty Lou. And I said, wow, God, you showed yourself. It's a miracle. You showed yourself, God. You showed yourself. It's a miracle. And so, Pretty Lou, we love you, man. And God bless you, man. And everything you stand for. And I told Pretty Lou, and I'll tell you all. Pretty Lou turns around. He has a high price to pay now for surviving. For beating a cancer that nobody beats. He has to inspire others. And go in person to these hospitals and do seminars and inspire the people out there struggling who have cancer. Now, I don't know if you know what would Big do, the greatest mixtape ever dropped, was taken off of the streaming. And it was a mixtape. And so this is crazy, y'all. Y'all don't understand. Hip hop culture lives off of mixtapes. And mixtape is free. It's giving back to the people. So me and Cooler Dre, we make this mixtape. It's incredible. CeeLo's on it. This one's on it. And it's the most phenomenal. Everybody's calling me. Everybody. So they pull it down. Fat Joe, you are disrespecting. You can't be rapping to this one's beat. You can't, but everybody in the world has done it. But Fat Joe, once again, you're too big. You got big ears on you. We got to pull it down. Now you find it wherever you find it. I don't even own it no more. And so I gave you a free mixtape, but that Joe Crack can't do it. Yeah, man, your shout is gone. It'll be dead. It'll be dead. And so, disgusting. Summer Jam. Let's be clear. Shout out to B.O., T.T. Torres, Ebro, My Home, Hot 97. The shit was a hurricane. Right? So you people were like, yo, why don't you recap Summer Jam? I'm like, how do you want me to recap Summer Jam when the shit was a hurricane. And so I don't know why they really did it. I'm gonna be honest with you. Horrible weather. As I was going on stage, I got an alert that said, tornado coming. I can't make this shit up. As I'm going on stage, they're saying, a tornado's coming. This, I'm like, yo, what the fuck? And hip hop, don't respect the COVID. Don't respect a hurricane. They want to see their favorite artists. Now, if I give you a very small synopsis, of Summer Jam. Everybody had ponds. This shit was a hot mess. And the ones I want to really salute is the women in hip hop. Because when I tell you that I threw on this big ass yellow product, shit was fly. But it was some big raincoat shit. And we dressed for the fucking hurricane and all this shit. But the ladies was dressed like it wasn't raining. They had their hair done. Remy Ma, Cardi B, Lil' Kim. They was acting like show must go on. And I'm looking like, what the fuck? I'm dressing like, hopefully I don't blow away. The weather's so fucked up. Now, shout out to the baby, the artist, he apologized 36 million times. It's time we move on and we respect what he said. And he came out there and he rocked the crowd and people showed him love. It's time to move past what's going on with the baby. Something about Summer Jam, no matter what, it rains every single fucking year. They might start having to look into a stadium with a roof. I mean, I would think, y'all, zone, my brother Swiss Beats. I would think that after 10 years in a row, 20 years in a row of a fucking tornado, Summer Jam would get a roof and do it somewhere indoor. Madison Square Garden went somewhere, bro. And so, a Boogie, very impressed. Now you have to understand, I suffered that day. The executive producer is in here. After I did my show and sweat my ass off because I had this plastic shit on, the Prada shit, I go up to a booth, a suite that I rented for my daughter and her friends. And so I go up there and I'm like, Ma, who's next? Oh, Bobby Smurder ain't come out yet, Dad. Hey, Boogie. I'm like, God damn. So now, you know, I kept it real, like the realest father in the world. And so I'm like, she names three more groups. I wanted to leave at that point right there. I wanted to go home. But trying to be the real deal, I stood and I was like, damn, there's only three more. It was horrible. But Summer Jam is iconic. It's the real deal. We did a tribute to DMX. That's another reason I had to come, because it's for X. Had it been anything else, I probably would have skated live and stood home. The weather was, I mean, this shit was a monsoon. It was a really serious thing. And I go, how the fuck you going on stage with the shit saying hurricane warning, tornado? Come on, y'all gotta stop, man. Like really, Hot 97, y'all gotta stop. I love you, I worship you, TT. I love Bill, but y'all gotta stop. You're throwing a show when the shit is a hurricane. Unbelievable shit. Swiss Beats put on a hell of a show. He brought Ron Isley. He had Lil' Kim. Of course, the Locks. Jadakiss did the freestyle. That shit was crazy. He brought it back. We came out, me and Remy leaned back. She did Andy up with M.O.P. Busta Rhymes and Slippers out there. Now we put our foot in their ass, man. Erica Ford was good. Now we put our foot in their ass. CNN, we did the Central Park shit. Me, Busta, LL, Melly Mel, and Mr. Ness. A Boogie once again, Remy Ma. Like, we've been putting our foot in these people's asses. If you follow me on Instagram, you saw Drew Barrymore in the projects. She wants to buy. She wants you to know that yesterday's price is not today's price.